Dear sisters and brothers, peace be upon you, your family, near and dear ones. Welcome to First Cry Mom's Kitchen. In today's video, I am going to share with you the South Indian style spicy chicken basmati biryani with proper and perfect measurements so that even a beginner can cook like a pro. This is a recipe of 3/4 quarter chicken biryani, sufficient for a nuclear family. For 3/4 quarters of rice, I have taken here 1 kilogram chicken, cleaned and washed. It had to be marinated and kept for at least half an hour. For better and best taste, the chicken had to be more in quantity than the rice. To marinate, add 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of chili powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala, 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste, 150 ml of curd, thick curd. Mix it well with hands, keep it aside for 30 to 45 minutes until we are done with the rest of the preparation. I am using this tumbler to measure the quantity of rice. It can hold 250 grams. Wash the rice well and soak it with some mint leaves and some food color to give good color for the biryani. For the gravy, we may need 300 to 350 grams of tomatoes and onions in measurement. In numbers, it can vary according to the size. I have used 3 medium-sized onions, 4 medium-sized tomatoes. Onions should be thinly sliced. 4 spicy green chilies I have taken here. You can use according to your taste. A handful of coriander leaves, 2 handfuls of mint leaves. I have used the mixture of ghee and sunflower oil. In quantity, it measures 150 ml. Here I have taken 6 cloves, 6 to 8 small pieces of cinnamon stick and 2 cardamoms. In hot oil, splutter the whole garam masala and add in onions and fry until it's golden. Add required amount of salt. Here I have added 2 tablespoons. Meanwhile, we'll get ready with the ginger garlic paste. 6 generous tablespoons of ginger garlic paste is required. In weight, it is 150 grams. I'm mentioning the quantity of the ingredients in both measurement and number so that it can be easy for the beginners. In goes 150 grams of ginger garlic paste. Ginger garlic paste can stick to the vessel, so constantly stir the onions. Time to add tomatoes, pudina or leaves, coriander leaves and green chilies. In this stage, we can add more spices like chili powder if we want the biryani to be more spicy. I have added 1 teaspoon. The tomatoes are well cooked now. It's time to add the marinated chicken. The bowl with some water and pour in. Allow the chicken to cook in high flame for 10 to 15 minutes until oil separates on the top. Also, the chicken will ooze out some water. Now time to add in water and rice. The water and rice ratio is 1:1. As I have used 3 tumblers of rice, I am supposed to pour in 3 tumblers water, but as there was at least 200 ml of water after the chicken has cooked and oozed out some water, I have adjusted the water level to 2.5 tumblers instead of 3, because right amount of water is very important when we cook in pressure cooker. Drain the rice completely before putting it inside the cooker. The tip to cook biryani in pressure cooker is that only one layer of water should be over the rice. Now it's good to go.
Cook the rice on medium flame for one whistle. It may take around 15 to 20 minutes. The yummy and spicy South Indian style basmati chicken biryani is ready now. 1, 2, 3. Steamy, hot, spicy chicken basmati biryani is ready. Please be safe with your near and dear ones. I hope this video is beneficial in any way to any of the viewers watching. Thank you for watching.